से ये है कि अभी अभी हमने आपकी आपका एक सॉन्ग देखा जननी, इतना मेस्मराइजिंग, इतना खूबसूरत कि मैं बता नहीं सकती हूँ उसका एक्सपीरियंस। राजा मौली जी का जो सिनेमा है वो बहुत अलहदा है, ये तो हम जानते हैं, बहुत अलग तरह का है, लेकिन आप खुद एक डायरेक्टर हैं, तो डायरेक्टर के पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से आपको उनकी क्या चीज़ सबसे ज़्यादा अपील की, बहुत ज़्यादा इम्प्रेसिव?
राजा मौली जी का जो सिनेमा है वो अलग नहीं है, वो एक ही सिनेमा है, इनका ही सिनेमा है सिर्फ। कोई और उस किस्म का सिनेमा बनाने की कोशिश करता भी होगा तो आई थिंक बहुत मुश्किल अचीव करना। सो इनकी सोच बहुत बड़ी के अलावा बिल्कुल अलग है, एंड आई रिमेंबर हिम टेलिंग मी, और बहुत अर्दी है। और इन्होंने मुझे एक बात बताई थी, ये इन्होंने कैरेक्टर्स की स्टडी कहाँ से की है, और हर रोज़ ये हर नए किस्म की वर्जन, नए वर्जन की एक महाभारत पढ़ते हैं, और महाभारत एक ऐसी है कि उसमें दुनिया का कोई कैरेक्टर नहीं बचा जो उसमें नहीं है। आप कोई भी कैरेक्टर पकड़ लीजिए दुनिया के किसी कोने से, वो वहीं से निकला हुआ होगा। सो आई थिंक वो जो कैरेक्टराइजेशन करते हैं और वो जो उस हिसाब से सोचते हैं और कैरेक्टर्स के पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से सोचते हैं, आई थिंक इट इज़ फैबुलस।
Hi sir, over here straight. I have two questions, one for Rajamouli sir and one for NTR sir. This is Himesh from Pink Villa.
First, Himesh.
Hi sir. Firstly, the trailer looks outstanding, so congratulations on that. Rajamouli sir, my first question to you is, you know, NTR sir is actually known to be fire in Telugu cinema and Ram Charan sir is known to be the ice. And you have cast them as a contrast over here. So could you tell us the idea behind casting the two of them as fire and ice in a contrasting way?
To tell it commercially, if I show them how the other directors have shown them, then I won't be special. So I want to be special, and so I. But see why I chose them for that characters is the characterization itself, right? There are certain aspects of Bheem that can be portrayed only by NTR. There are certain portions, certain characteristics of Ram that can be portrayed only by Charan. So the characters made me choose them for their roles rather than their images. Yeah.
Okay. And NTR sir, firstly, welcome to Mumbai and welcome to Hindi cinema.
Thank you.
RRR.
Thank you so much.
So my question to you is, do you believe an SS Rajamouli film is the perfect vehicle for any actor to, you know, go to a pan-India film? Because after this, your lineup are all, you know, multilinguals, be it Kotala, Shiva, or the other films, Prashant, all the... So do you think this is the perfect vehicle for you to enter into this space?
Absolutely. Why not? Seriously, absolutely. And yeah, you know, it's like, you know, especially when you... see, let me... not talk about the business aspect in this, but as an actor, for me, Rajamouli has been one director who's always satisfied my thirst of wanting to do something new. Something, you know, an actor should not be very comfortable. He should not. And Rajamouli is one of the very, very, very few directors who's tickled that part in me. It's not only the films he does with me, but in general also, you know, when we discuss, you know, he's been a very close friend for a very long time in my life. And when I discuss scripts, you know, he's this person in my life who pushes me to get out of my comfort zone. And as you said, you know, being a part of RRR has really opened out a lot of doors for me as an actor. And I'm very happy to accept it also.
Thank you so much and looking forward.
Thank you, Umesh. Thanks a lot.
I don't think so. I don't think there is any space that he's not comfortable with. He's lying.
Hello, Rajamouli sir, just next to him. Russell De Silva from Bollywood Life. First of all, I have to repeat it again to everybody saying this. Congratulations to the entire team. This trailer is probably one of the best we've ever seen in world cinema. So, congratulations on that. What I wanted to ask you first, Rajamouli sir, is that... after Bahubali, it's obviously that kind of expectations are too high everywhere, throughout the country, throughout the world. Now, when you're making a movie as an artist, as a creator, you have to concentrate on the subject. but how difficult it is also to know that everybody is expecting a bigger movie than Bahubali, and everybody is expecting a bigger performance at the box office than Bahubali. How do you separate that?
Well, there is obviously a lot of people will be expecting the same kind of film after Bahubali, but we can't keep making the same films again and again. But the trick is, if you look deeply, they are not looking, the audience are not waiting for another Bahubali. They are waiting for the kind of experience they had in the film, the kind of emotion they felt in the film. That is what they want. But they can't tell you that. They don't have that much of analyzation to tell you that. So they'll simply say, we need another Bahubali. But what people want is the same kind of emotion, the same kind of highs that they got in the film. And again, I'm aware of the kind of expectations the people have. Like I said, I will be banking more on the story, on the characters, and the relationship between the characters, and the emotional highs that we get when we watch the characters. And anyone, any section of audiences that come to the theater, the trailers or your previous track records or the heroes' images, everything will only help us bring them to the theater. The moment they come into the theaters, 2-3 minutes into the film, they'll be watching what the film is, not what we did before. Right? So I'll be banking more on my story and my emotions rather than my previous track record.
Also, sir, there was a time in the 80s and up till the early 90s, we did see this kind of pan-India cinema, which people, it has now become a regular word. The word didn't exist back then. There was like Giriftar, Amitabh Bachchan, Rajnikanth, Kamal Hassan came together. There was Andha Kanun. There was Pratibandh with Chiranjeevi sir and Juhi Chawla. Looking back, do you think so that you are starting that trend again of getting all these big stars of different industries together and making that thing again?
Yeah, first of all, I believe I told that many times before, if you believe on your core storytelling, you don't need to worry about languages. No, whether it is Telugu, Tamil, South, Hindi, North, Northeastern, it doesn't matter, because the language is just a medium of communication. What is actually communicating to the people is the story that we are telling. Words are just small bridges. The visuals are the, in cinema, the visual is what tells you the story. And the language doesn't matter. When the language doesn't matter, you are banking on which is the best actor to suit the role. For example, I have the character played by Ajay sir. I didn't approach him because I have a relationship with him. I didn't approach him because, okay, I have a Tarak and Charan from Tamil and we have Ajay sir from the North. Then it will have a big, nice commercial combination. That is not how I approach it. When we are writing the character, we think, who has the image that can carry this role? The immediate name that propped up in all our story department is Ajay Devgn. No, I immediately called him and said, sir, I need 15 minutes of your time. No, and I narrated him his role. The first answer, the first question he asked me is, when do you need my dates? So when things fall in place, they fall in place that way, when you approach it in the right way. Of course, commercials are important to everyone, but if your story leads your way, then everything will fall into place.
And one last small question to Junior NTR, sir, because this is the first time. Big fan, Ajay Lava Kusa, Janata Garaj are two of my favorite movies.
Thank you so much.
So I just wanted to ask, when you're doing a Rajamouli film, people know that you have to not dedicate dates, you have to dedicate years to that movie.
Basically dedicating your whole lifetime.
Yes. So between Arvinda, Samhita, and then now this is coming, RRR, how many movies that you were offered and you had to let it go by because you know this is too special?
I was offered only one movie, Triple R. Do you think even someone would even dare come up and ask for your dates when Rajamouli is doing a movie? Impossible.
Somebody may have guts.
Nahi, waisa nahi hota hai, yaar. You know, it's like you just have to. Yeah, I mean, nahi. You know, this doesn't happen in our industry when you're working for a movie with Jakanna. You're there. You know you're in there for a long time, and you have to accept it. The sooner you accept, the better it is.
Alia ji, on your left, hi. On your left, hi. Alia ji, आजकल का जो सबसे ट्रेंडिंग अल्फाबेट है वो है आर. सो आपकी भी लाइफ में एक बहुत बड़े आर हैं, तो आप मानती हैं कि आर बहुत लकी फैक्टर है आपके लिए?
I'm stumped. मेरे पास जवाब नहीं है. I'm trying to be intelligent right now. I don't have a good answer. R is a lovely alphabet, but so is A. Should I tell them the true story? So actually, story बहुत interesting है, because I bumped into Rajamouli sir at the airport. He was just coming back from something, and I was going to Hyderabad for a shoot, and I said, sir, I want to work with you. And he said, you know, he was very gracious, said, yes, I would love to work with you as well. I said, sir, I'll do anything. Just give me a part in your film. I want to work with you. It was a casual meeting. It just happened. And at the end of that, he said, actually, I do have something, but I'm not sure. I wasn't sure whether I should approach you. I'm not sure about your timeline. And I said, I couldn't believe my luck, firstly. I couldn't believe that there was actually something for me. I said, sir, whatever it is, I'll come, I'll meet you. And then, of course, it became more legitimate. We did a Zoom call. Then I went to Hyderabad, and sir took me through the film. And as I said, I would do a walk-on part on sir's film, because just being a part of his vision and his cinema is, like I said, a dream come true for me. But my reaction was purely like, and he was like, he was speaking about the character earlier. He said, it's very important for me that you match the character, because Sita is very, very loved. And the representation of, the way you portray her on screen, your look, the way you speak, your energy, everything has to be up to the mark, because, I have to live up to the audience's visualization and characterization that they already have of her. So I took that very, very seriously, and I worked for a year on my lines. I said, so I won't let you down. I think the most scary part was I had to speak in Telugu. I think I managed eventually.
Hello. Mera sawal, your left. मेरा सवाल अजय सर, आलिया मैम और एनटीआर सर तीनों से है. राहुल हियर फ्रॉम द फिल्मी चर्चा. क्रांतिकारियों की कुर्बानी की बात करें तो हम आम इंसान बस देखते हैं, सुनते हैं, किताबों में पढ़े हैं, लेकिन आपके लिए बहुत गर्व की बात है कि आप लोग उस कहानी के हिस्सा बने हैं और ऑन स्क्रीन कैरेक्टर प्ले कर रहे हैं, उस किरदार का हिस्सा हैं आप. तो हम लोग महसूस नहीं कर सकते क्या, आप लोग कुछ फील करते हैं उनकी कुर्बानी, उनकी लड़ाई ऑन स्क्रीन प्ले करते वक्त, कुछ ऐसा? तीनों बारी बारी से आंसर.
कुछ कैरेक्टर्स ऐसे होते हैं जब आप बहुत कुछ महसूस करते हैं. मुझे याद है कि एक ऐसा कैरेक्टर जो मैंने प्ले किया था, जो मैंने बहुत ज़्यादा महसूस किया था, उनका नाम था भगत सिंह. क्योंकि उनकी जब हम कहानियाँ सुनते थे कि वो जो फिल्म में था वो तो ठीक है, जो असली ज़िंदगी में भी वो क्या थे, उनके आई थिंक 90 से ऊपर की उम्र के भाई हमारे सेट पर आया करते थे, और वो जब कहानियाँ सुनाते थे तो आपका पूरा थॉट प्रोसेस, आपकी ऐसे लगता है कि अगर 6 महीने और शूटिंग चलती तो आप एज अ ह्यूमन बीइंग बदल जाते. मतलब कि इतना फर्क पड़ता है कई बार.
हेलो हेलो राजमौली गारू,
एक सेकंड सर, आई विल कम टू यू.
वेल, आई हैव डन अ फिल्म कॉल्ड राजी, वेयर आई प्लेड कैरेक्टर ऑफ एन अनसंग हीरो. एंड आई थिंक आई कंप्लीटली agree with Ajay sir that agar aap 6 mahine aur ya 3 mahine aur ya 1 mahine aur us, you live that character, you really feel, because hum imagine nahi kar sakte hai what they have to do, what they go through, and how they put their lives at stake for the country and for their people. Hum imagine bhi nahi kar sakte. So living through the beats of the character and the psychology and what they go through is just a small part of it. Unhone actually wo actually guzre usse. So, of course, the awe and the appreciation and that the unimaginable gratitude that we feel. These are ye sirf shabd hai jo actually guzarte, especially the families, you know, that, you know, understand them and support them. It's another world altogether. So I think, jaisa said, hum jitna bhi kahe wo kam hoga.
I didn't get your name. Rahul. Brother, kuch characters aise hote hai ki paidashi se jab, you know, we've heard their stories. Hum unki kahaniyan sun ke bade hue hain. To jab aise characters karne ke liye, when you have an opportunity, hum bas memory lane mein chale jate hain aur bas you start remembering those stories. And somewhere you feel that you really don't need to work hard for it. Kyunki they've tumhari zindagi ke already wo hissa ban chuke hain. So you're playing yourself there. You're not playing some character. So these are the freedom fighters. These are the great people who've become a part of your life already. So you're playing yourself.
Alia?
So there wasn't a special effort for this. And of course, when you have a director like Rajamouli, who is ready to guide you, it becomes very easy. I'm trying here. You know, if there's... No, bas agar, if there are any mistakes, please. You know, I'm ready to accept it, but... thank you.
Alia, hi, this is Vinamru from Midday. So my question to you is that when you were finalized to play the character of Sita, as an actor, what were your emotions like on the first day of the shoot and the last day of the shoot?
Emotions? I was very excited, but I was also very nervous because it's an unknown language. I mean, I know the language, I've studied and I've gone through my part, I've rattled it, I'm sitting every day with my coach and I'm going through it. But at the end of the day, I think maybe in Hindi or English, I don't think in Telugu, but I was very nervous because I wanted to portray the line, give the right pauses, give the right... But once I went on set, I realized that sir had done everything for me. It was literally, I would not say, he made it so much easier because he's so clear exactly what he wants. Every line, every shot, every emotion. And then I was just observing. Then I was like, literally like an audience and, you know, watching him. He would also perform it in front of the camera and he would do this. And then I would try and imitate him and do the same thing. So the emotions were excitement to get it right. And of course, once it was done, I was... quite sad when I experienced with sir's over, but hopefully I'll have another one.
Sir,
Rajamouli garu,
sir.
Thank you so much, sir. Malli ikkada kochinanduku, NTR anna garu, thank you so much, sir. Mumbai kochinanduku. Na question entante mee anna garu, NTR anna garu meeke meeku biggest difficulty eppudu anpichindi sir, shooting lona ante RRR shooting lona?
Okay, his question was
I understood the question. What was the biggest difficulty while shooting the film RRR? I've understood. Let me tell you, on set, before you answer that question, NTR and Ram Charan were always talking to each other in Telugu, in front of me. And I was always looking like one tennis ball, left, right, center, waiting for somebody to translate it to me. Now I'll start
translating.
No
way.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
No. There were so many times, we really felt that, you know what, we should not talk in Telugu and make sure we speak in English or Hindi so that Alia understands what we're talking about.
No, you all were purposely
trying to
travel.
Maybe we were rehearsing our lines or dialogue or whatever. But yeah, every part of shooting for RRR was really demanded a lot from us. As actors, as individuals, we really had to put in our heart and soul for it. Because that man there has put in that much of belief in us. So we'll have to deliver it. We had to. So every part of shooting for RRR was really difficult, especially the action sequences were, oh my God, they were torturous.
Sir,
thank you so much, sir.
Who's your left? Sir? Yeah.
Just a sec.
Sir,
he wants to complete. Just a sec.
Okay.
I'll come to
sir.
You. Please.
Sir, I'm miss out now, sir. Ram Charan gar ikkada ralenanduko.
Main kuda chala miss out now. Akkada, there was a sudden puja in the wedding ceremony which he had to attend to. So, we really tried until the last minute to bring him in, but you know how the pujaris are. You know, so yeah. We have to obey them.
Ma'am, ek dialogue Telugu mein bol sakte ho kya? NTR sir ne abhi.
No, Hyderabad ajna ur Telugu la maatladdam.
Thank you so much. Yes, please.
Okay, next, please.
Yeah, sir, NTR sir.
Yes.
Basically, the hooks that what we are saying currently, natu natu natu.
the step has been very much famous in like short period of time. There has been more than 10,000 reels are seeing up. There are more hits on it, where you see more 10 lakhs of views and likes are there on your complete one that hook step in very short period of time. I just want to know how much time it took for you to practice that and the bond, which, because that's quite a kind of tuning with the step. Was it so easy or tough?
It was actually a very easy step. I'm not trying to tell you it's a very tough step. A very easy step, yeah. Just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and that's it. It's actually very easy. But I don't know. It's him who's made it feel very tough. we were, you know, because of the pandemic, we couldn't shoot here in India. So he took us all the way to Kiev in Ukraine and tortured us there. I mean, 18 takes for that step. Purely because he wanted us to, you know, like, he would sit in front of the monitor and step freeze the step so that the coordination, the sync between me and Charan is like on dot. I mean, how can you do it? I went up to him and said, see, both of us have different styles of dancing. So as a director, bring that style together. He's like, no. I said, it is my style.
Because it was Rajamouli sir's style, right? It was his idea.
Absolutely. So every day, well, I don't know, yeah. You know, even the weather was so, you know, like we were very unlucky. The sun would set at 8 in the night and it would rise at 6 in the morning. So 8 ke baad, 9 baje tak, he would make us go through the rehearsal. Again, start off at 6 in the morning. So I was like, why did we do these rehearsals when you're automatically any which way is going to take 20 takes there?
Okay, Rajamouli sir, one more
torturous.
Question. Okay, Rajamouli sir, one more question to you. Rajamouli sir, yeah, one more question.
I'll come to you.
Sir, you have done a movie like Magadir. And like, Rajamouli sir, yeah. Magadir.
Magadir, yeah.
Which were like a great hit in South and which were accepted worldwide currently. And now you have come up with RRR, which is a great combination of Bollywood and, you know, South combination together. So is it a new trend going to be in future where we can see more of Bollywood and South actors collaborating together and seeing such kind of movie?
Yeah, I think so. It is just a mental block that, you know, North actors have to act only in Hindi films and South actors have to act only in the South Indian languages. It's just a mental block. At the end of... why we cast them is because they are great actors and acting doesn't have a language. So it is just a mental block that we have. Once we remove the mental block, then we have a big array of actors whom you can approach and say, see, this is the character kind of character that we have. Are you interested? And I'm not an actor, but I'm pretty sure all of them want to do challenging characters. So if they have more directors approaching from different languages and so showing them, asking them, this is the kind of character I have written for you, I think they also will be very interested. I think, yes, in future, you'll be seeing more collaborations in languages.
Hi, this is Sarita Singh.
नहीं जैसे कि कह रहे हैं आई थिंक कल को कुछ भी हो सकता है हम सब अच्छे लोग अच्छे टेक्नीशियंस अच्छे अच्छा काम करना चाहते हैं सब मिलके और अगर अगर दो एनर्जीज और ये साथ में मिलके अगर बहुत अच्छा काम कर सकती हैं तो व्हाई नॉट
हाय दिस
frankly, I didn't receive any offers from Hollywood, but like I said, I want to make Indian films, whether it's Hollywood or whatever, I would like to make Indian films, even if I get an offer from some other industry. I would want to make an Indian film, Indian story, and present it to them. Wow. No, that's how I want that.
Hi, this is Sarita Singh from FIFA Poos. Rajamouli sir and entire team, first of all, thank you so much for this wonderful trailer. Each frame of it is sure treat to watch. I'm just waiting. मेरा सवाल अजय देवगन और एनटीआर से है कि आप दोनों बहुत बड़े सुपरस्टार्स हो, दोनों का अपना एक ऑरा है, दोनों का अपना एक स्टाइल है. आप दोनों का एक दूसरे के साथ काम करने का एक्सपीरियंस कैसा रहा? और साथ ही साथ मैं चाहूँगी कि अजय देवगन आता माजी सटकली बोले और एनटीआर जी उसे कॉपी करें और ये एक परफेक्ट कॉम्बिनेशन होगा जब फैंस जाकर के आप दोनों को साथ में देखेंगे.
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड जस्ट लाइक टू टेल यू समथिंग.
Don't tell anything. Please.
I mean, it's. Please do not even compare me with Ajay sir, for his seniority, for a man he is. We were kids. We grew up watching his films, and he was our very own action superstar then and even now. So I still remember his entry in Phool Aur Kante, you know, where he was standing on top of a bike, and I was like, "Yaar, aisa kaise ho sakta hai? Yaar, can I do it?" And my mom was like, "No, this is movie, and it happens only in movies. This doesn't happen in real life." I mean, like, see, I've watched my grandfather's films, my uncle's films. You know, we've watched a lot of films, but that entry for me was like crazy. So please, you know, when I worked with him, with Ajay sir, it was like working with a guru. I mean, we didn't have the opportunity to share screen space with him. But the small opportunity I had to go and like visit the sets when he was working, it really felt very, you know, it was, you know, I cherished it a lot. You know, seeing such a gentleman and that's about it for me. That's my feeling.
Jaisa ki inhone kaha. Anyways, thank you for making me feel so old.
I was expecting that.
But हाँ, हमारा काम screen पे हम साथ में नहीं हैं film में, but shooting के वक्त इन्होंने visit किया था and it was we had a great time. We had lunch together. Yes. And it was lovely.
आता माजी सटकली.
साथ में नहीं, I'll say you repeat. आता माजी सटकली.
That's from Singham, right?
ठीक है. जयंती सर हियर. कप के लिए खड़े रहना. क्या कहना चाहेंगे आप और जिस तरह का रेस्पॉन्स आज मिल रहा है ट्रेलर को, डू यू थिंक हाफ द बैटल इज वॉन?
सबसे पहले तो राजामौली जी की फिल्म मतलब सोचना ही नहीं था, लेकिन जैसे इन्होंने बोला लैंग्वेज और बैरियर नहीं होता, मेरे साथ बहुत हुआ. क्योंकि धनया जी प्रोड्यूसर हैं और इनको हिंदी नहीं आती, मुझे इंग्लिश नहीं आती. तो मतलब हम लोग नंबर पे ही पेपर पे लिखते थे और एक दूसरे को समझते थे कि हम राजामौली जी तक कैसे भी करके कन्विंस करके ये मुझे इस फिल्म का हिस्सा बनाएंगे. तो मुझे कोई ऐसा ये नहीं था कि और दूसरा इनकी फिल्म जो हमें हमारे पार्टनर हैं संजय जी, अमिताभ जी जो डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन कर रहे हैं पेन मरुधर, और हम लोग की टीम, इस ये पहली फिल्म होगी जो हर प्लेटफॉर्म पे देखने मिलेगी. कभी पार्टनरशिप नहीं होती कि जी पे आने वाली फिल्म स्टार पे नहीं दिखती, तो ये पहली फिल्म होगी कि जो हर प्लेटफॉर्म पे देखने मिलेगी.
मेरा
दो आखिरी सवाल लेंगे.
हाँ मैम, प्लीज. एनटीआर, थैंक यू सो मच जो आपने अजय सर के लिए कहा, और हम सब उस बात से इतफाक करते हैं और एग्री करते हैं. इज वन ऑफ द फैंटास्टिक एक्टर वी हैव इन द इंडस्ट्री. राजामौली सर, आपसे पूछना चाहूँगा, बहुत सुल्तान, मिर्ज़ा, मलिक, अनगिनत किरदार, आप खाली अजय देवगन का नाम डालिए और आपको लगेगा जहन में दुनिया भर के किरदार आ जाएंगे. ट्रेलर वाकई में बहुत बढ़िया है, लेकिन फिर भी मुझे लगा कि अजय सर जब बहुत कम आए हैं वो दुखता है कहीं. कोई इंटेंशनल करा है आपने कि सरप्राइज पैकेज होगा, इस वजह से रखा है ऐसा?
इट इज़ नॉट द the duration that matters, it is the impact that matters.
Alia, what's your take on this? Impact is matter.
I agree. You know, I do. No, and I'm not genuine. I genuinely mean it. I think it's what effect you have on the storyline of the film. You know, it and sometimes you don't need, you ek look hi kar jata hai, ek dialogue hi kar jata hai. It's the way you are presented, and that one moment or those two moments or whatever doesn't matter. It's how you fit in the storyline. So I feel ke big, small, duration, wo sab, that's just, you know, coffee table conversation. That doesn't matter.
Ajay sir, agar aap kuch kehna chahe.
Nahin, bilkul. Kahani ke liye kitna zaruri hai wo kirdar. कई कैरेक्टर्स 2 मिनट 5 मिनट 10 मिनट 15 मिनट या आधा घंटा जितनी भी देर के लिए स्क्रीन पे होते हैं, बट आप सोचते कई बार कास्टिंग करते वक्त कि अगर मैं अपने कैरेक्टर की बात नहीं कर रहा हूँ, जनरली कुछ कैरेक्टर्स इतने इंपॉर्टेंट होते हैं कहानी के बेस के लिए कि आपको उसमें ऐसा कोई इंसान चाहिए होता है जो एक इम्पैक्ट छोड़ के जाए. तो कई बार हम ऐसे बहुत सारे एक्टर्स के पास जाते हैं कि यार इट्स नॉट द लेंथ, लेकिन ये कर दो बिकॉज इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर फॉर द फिल्म, और वो सब समझते हैं और उस हिसाब से करते हैं. तो बेसिकली लेंथ की बात नहीं है, वो कैरेक्टर कहानी के लिए कितना ज़रूरी है वो ज़्यादा इम्पोर्टेंट.
ऑलराइट,
सो एक सवाल
जी जी जी
जयंती भाई आपसे एक सवाल है कि अक्सर ये कहा जाता है कि हमारी फिल्म इंडस्ट्री, लेकिन इस फिल्म इंडस्ट्री का हम भी हिस्सा है, अगर थिएटर्स में फिल्म नहीं चलती हैं तो हमारे लिए भी बहुत नुकसान होता है, हम किसके लिए लिखेंगे. तो मेरा सवाल आपसे ये है कि जिस तरह से सूर्यवंशी के बाद ये आस हमारी थोड़ी सी कम हो गई थी, वो इस फिल्म के साथ कितनी ज़्यादा होगी, क्योंकि सूर्यवंशी का जो अनुमान लगाया गया था उससे कहीं ज़्यादा उसने बिजनेस किया, तो ये जो ट्रिपल आर है उसका आप क्या सोचते हैं?
ये इतनी बड़ी फिल्म है, ये बोल सकते हैं कि जो हमारा पुराना जमाना था ये फिल्म से वापस आएगा कि और ये फिल्म के लिए डिजिटल वालों ने भी एग्री किया है कि 75 to 90 डेज तक ये टेलीकास्ट नहीं करेंगे. इसका मतलब ये इतनी बड़ी फिल्म चलने वाली है. बाकी अभी सब फिल्में 30 डेज़ के लिए वो निगोशिएट करते हैं, ये पहली फिल्म है जो 75 to 90 डेज़ के बाद ही आएगी, तो लोग थिएटर में ही देखेंगे ये.
थैंक यू सो मच. जस्ट वन लास्ट थिंग. या
आलिया, जस्टिन हियर फ्रॉम पीटीआई टुवर्ड्स यू, राइट? हाय आलिया, व्हेन आरआरआर एंड गंगूबाई वर सपोज्ड टू सॉर्ट ऑफ कम टुगेदर ऑलमोस्ट, as an actor, were you worried? What was the mental space like when two massive films were scheduled to release together?
Well, I think I am somebody who's very trusting of my directors and producers, and that's the reason they are who they are. S.S. Rajamouli is who he is because of his mind. Sanjay Leela Bhansali is who he is because of his mind and his, you know, understanding of cinema. So it's nothing for me to worry. Even in that moment, I was like, क्या होगा, इट विल बी आलिया वर्सेस आलिया, अजय वर्सेस अजय, अजय सर इन दैट फिल्म एज वेल. बट इवेंचुअली इट्स नॉट हैपनिंग दैट वे. गंगूबाई इज रिलीजिंग ऑन द 18th ऑफ फेब्रुअरी एंड वे ऑल हैप्पी. जयंतीलाल भाई इज आल्सो पार्ट ऑफ द बोथ फिल्म्स.
इसमें आलिया जी का बहुत अच्छा रोल है, ये बोल सकते हैं इन्होंने डेट शिफ्ट करवाई.
नहीं नहीं, मैंने कुछ नहीं किया, मैंने कुछ नहीं किया. वट एवर इज डन इज इट हैंडल्ड बाई द प्रोड्यूसर्स एंड द डायरेक्टर्स एंड आई एम जस्ट फॉलो. मैं तो बस एक्टर हूँ, आप मेरे को यहाँ बिठाओ वहाँ बिठाओ, आई विल डू व्हाट यू टेल मी टू डू.
Right, thank you.
Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. Ek baar zordaar taaliyan ho jaye for this amazing crew of RRR. And yes, we'll have a quick photo op. Yeah.